Hi folks, I'm still working with the VFD2s, and I remember sometimes ago I have done a movie to be able to reuse this board. This is a board of Cisco KeyMEM 3000, and the first thing I need to be able to reuse this board is remove the 8Mega88, is the processor control the all the board, and connect to the PT6302, and after I remove the processor, I connect the three wires from my processor direct to these points in this this processor. Okay, you can see the other video to check what I have done. Today I'm still working with a board from a TV satellite, and this board use the PT6302 also to control the VFD2, okay? And this board have also a PT6964, is a IC to control the keyboard and the infrared receiver, but and the LEDs, because they have a small LEDs here. But at this time I'm not used this IC. I only use PT6302. Okay, to be able to reuse the board, I need a power up with less 12 volts, plus 5 volts, and filament power. Okay, and to control the PT6302, I use Arduino, because some people ask if it's possible to do it with the Arduino. Okay, is done here in Arduino. Okay, let me try explain what is necessary to take care. Okay, I like have your attention to this part of the code. If you see this information is running in the VFD. Sometimes you receive the zero in the right, another time you receive the zero in the left. Okay, I do it this code to revert the string, to be more easy to some people understand why is necessary to revert the string if start from the right to the left or left to the right. Okay, pay attention to the code about the reverse of the strings. Okay. Okay, at the end of the video I will let the code, like I have done in some videos before, but now I like explain same changes necessary to do it to this this board to work. Here you can see the connector. Okay. These two parts have connection direct to the GND, and after start with pin 1 until pin 13. If you see here, the data in go to the pin 8 of the Arduino, CLK go to the pin 7, and pin 9 go to the strobe or the block. But the important thing you need to take care is, because this control pin go to the base of a transistor, and after connect through the pull-up resistor to the chip selector or strobe or block, how you prefer. Okay, this means if you control the Arduino, the pin strobe, you need invert this signal, because here the signal is inverted again. Okay, by this reason, if you looked in the code, you will see the strobe go to the height instead of go to the less. Okay. Is only a small attention is necessary to the code. Okay, I remember also here you need the three independent power source, because you need to connect the plus 12 volts to the ground of the circuit, and you need the power of the filament independent, because you need to connect this to the less 12 volts. Okay, here in the IC you see the connections of the pins. Here the pin 1 start count around is here the last 64, and here you see the less 12 volts is VAE, less 12 volts GND, oscillator in oscillator O, and reset chip selector or strobe, how you prefer, clock, data in, and VDD. Okay, after you put all these parts in the processor, you will go to be able to reuse this board. Is my Arduino, and here you can see the signal is a send. Okay, here a burst of the charters, and you see here, this is a part I like you take note here, instead of my strobe go to the low, go to the IG. Okay, because it's reverted, this signal is reverted. You can do it the suppress of the transistor here in the board. In this case is this small transistor 7902, and put the signal direct here, because this pin is connected to the 6302. Okay, this is a base, is coming through this small air, this small resistor, and here you have the connections of the connector. You have the strobe, you have the clock, and the data in. Okay, VCC and GND. Okay, look to the code now.